Hello everyone, and welcome to my walkthrough of The Legend of Zelda, Twilight Princess. Let's get this game started. As you see, I have a little practice file going on here, but that's not important, really. Alright, my name is, of course, Link. Well, actually, it's PkGam, but that's another story entirely. Now, what should I name my horse? Perfect! You thought I was gonna name it after one of those characters, didn't you? Oh no, I do something much more abnormal than that. Because it's just what I do in my videos. Oh, and here's a free brightness test for your monitor. No charge whatsoever. Let's get the game started. With a little introduction. I thought that only happens when I'm drunk. That doesn't make sense in my explanation, but it probably doesn't make sense in this game's storyline, of course. Yeah, sure, what the heck, it's what I do as a hero. Well, I have in other games. Sounds fun! Perhaps I'll be doing that in this walkthrough here. Yeah, I will. If that's not blatantly obvious, I mean, a walkthrough covers everything, after all. I just like to mess around a lot in my commentary. This game looks really good, I have to say. It does use a lot of bloom effects. If you don't know what a bloom effect is, it's like, see on the tops of those stick bushels that are on top of Anope over there. Yeah, like when they emphasize bright spots by making them glow a lot more, that's called bloom. But it looks really good in this game. Bye bye! We'll meet them later, by the way, if you didn't know that. In fact, we'll be meeting up with them very shortly. Hey, where are you taking my steed? No one's home. Crap, I shouldn't have said that. Oh, I guess I could. I was planning on sleeping in today, but I said someone stole my steed! Yeah, so I gotta go get Anope back. There's something... I was gonna say there's something in your basement to your house, but you can't get that right now. Anyway, I'm gonna talk to you. How's it going? Arr! Alright, let's go. You just go over here. And for the game's controls, you can't really do much right away. It starts out really simple. Control stick to move, A button to roll while running, A button to speak with people. You can lock onto things with the Z button and do sidesteps by jumping, by pressing the A button and while holding the Z button off to the side, and backflip, front flip with by pushing back and front on the control stick respectively. It's all very simple, basic stuff for Zelda stuff, and that's really all that you can do this early in the game. Oh, I suppose you could go into first person's perspective. If you press the C button on the nunchuck, you can look around, and yeah, this game uses the Wii remote and nunchuck. I'm playing the Wii version of the game, in case you can't tell. The GameCube version of this game is mirrored, so if you're playing the GameCube version of this game, this walkthrough will still help you. You just gotta do things in reverse. Bloom! See what I mean with the glow effects on the waterfall down there? And her shirt, actually. Oh, thank you, but I'm afraid I already called the police, so you might have to talk to some people over there, and yeah, because you stole my horse and all. I hope you can get that cleared up. Anyway... So if you go and talk to her, she'll be like, Anope is a girl too, so you have to treat her nice like one. Bro, listen, Link, can you do something for me? Can you use a piece of that grass to play that song for me? You know the one that Anope likes. I don't believe you can... Oh, you can actually get on her. Well, this is a little tutorial here. You grab onto the grass like that, and you blow it. And you play Epona's song. Oh, I mean Anope's song. And that'll make Anope come towards you wherever she may be in the world. That's a handy little thing to know there. Do you have anything else to say to me? Sounds good to me. Got anything more? Okay, that's good enough. if you press the A button, you can whip her a little bit and make her move faster. But as you can see, you use up those little sunburst slap things at the bottom of the screen. And they regenerate over time, or after you transition from screen to screen. Anyway, that guy is gone, in case you didn't realize that. Now we go over here. I don't know why I even stopped there. I should have just turned left. I just wanted to make that observation, I suppose. You can tell that there's a little map at the bottom right corner there of the screen. Not right now, during a cutscene, of course. But you'll see once it pops out of it. Ah, such beauty. Such bloom. And that's the guy we have to meet up. Well, actually not there, but near the area. But we're gonna talk to some people. Oh my goodness, it's Rosie O'Donnell. What are you doing back? It seems like you were in just about every game that I play nowadays, I swear. Well, he sounds rather useless. you basically can talk to groups of people like that at certain times, and you don't have to talk to them again at all. Grab the chicken, because you can grab the chicken! Cuckoo! Chicken! Grab! Okay, I'm not really gonna waste time with that. I just like doing weird stuff for the fun of it, to burn a little time and whatnot. Let's talk to them and actually meet up with them for real this time. But yeah, you can actually grab the cuckoos over there if you are quick enough to be able to grab them. You probably have to sneak up to them. And I would like to talk to her, please, if at all possible. I'd really like to talk to her. You know what? I'll talk to you instead. I've never had so much trouble talking to people in my life. Interesting. That does sound like something that I would like to have. Now, let me talk to the pregnant lady. Yep, that's what I gotta do. Anyway, I'm wasting a lot of time here. I'm just showing you around the village, per se. And Anope is rather hard to navigate through the village at times. In case you don't realize that. But it's not that bad, though. And you won't have to ride on her through these tight areas all the time. It's just early in the game that's like this. It's not that bad to do, and you can definitely get the hang of it. I'm just a little clunky with her. I'm not used to riding Nope, but I will be needing her in this area right here. This is the Ordon Ranch. Those are the goats that I have to herd. Little cutscene should take place. Oh no, I have to talk to the guy first, I'm sure. Okay, there we go. No big deal, I suppose. I am a hero after all, it's what I do. Sure, it's just... Okay, here's how you herd. The objective is to get them... See that barn over there? Way at the upper left corner there, next to your life gauge. I'll get into life gauge a little later when I'm actually in some sort of danger. Anyway, what you want to do is coax the goats to move towards the barn by moving behind them. If you approach them from the side, they will move away from the barn, and obviously that's not going to work for you. So just carefully get them going. You don't have to go and do this fast or anything like that. In fact, moving fast might actually hinder you from doing this properly and getting them all into the barn at once. I already got a couple goats in there. Getting those rascals. I guess they're apparently very skittish nowadays. I don't know why. Maybe they're sensing an approaching danger or something like that. Nah, that couldn't be. I mean, this is a video game. That sort of stuff just doesn't happen in video games, you know? Alright, you go in there. You two, stop. No, don't you dare go that way. Don't. Stop. Why are you doing this to me? Back the other way, please. Why are you giving me trouble? Come on. You can do it. It's nice and warm in there. There you go. Voila! And that's goat herding 101. You're welcome. Yeah, sure, that sounds good to me. That's kind of like a complete turnaround from relaxing. And he first says to relax, and then he says that he's going to get some fences set up for me to practice on, which sounds rather invigorating, actually. Okay, so this is how this works with Anope. She can jump fences if you dash at them by pressing the A button and approaching fences straight on, like so. Woo! I said like so. I guess that wasn't straight on enough. It can be a tad finicky. It's sort of like Ocarina of Time, though not quite... Though not quite as finicky. Clearly, I am not used to riding her. So maybe I should be getting as much practice on these things as I possibly can. There we go. Now I just gotta jump this fence and then jump this fence to leave the place. There we go. Clearly, it is becoming nighttime. And yes, I would like to save. I will save right here. So I guess I was apparently working on the ranch all day, even though that took like less than a minute. Okay, that didn't take all day, because I seen it was at sunset by the time I got there, but still. Sunset is not a minute. I probably shouldn't question the game logic, otherwise, you know, the universe might implode. Why do people keep bugging me? I want to sleep in, dang it. Anyway, let's get out of here. So I'm going to plop down here, and you know what? I think this is a good time to end off the part, actually. Yeah, it's been about 15 minutes or so I think I'm going to end it off here. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next part when I go through that door and meet up with the kids.